times of crisis,
it's been a nightmare.
What you need is accurate,
COVID-19,
up-to-date, and in-depth information.
This virus will be with us for a long time.
And in this most challenging time, when the whole world is being ravaged by the most frightening pandemic, there's no easier way to stay informed than to stay home.
Hello everyone.
Welcome to Thai PBS World tonight.
And stay with us. Thai PBS World. We bring Thailand to the world.
สวัสดีค่ะ very good evening and welcome to our 7 o'clock news Thai PBS World tonight you are now with me Natha Gomulwadin live from Thai PBS studio in Bangkok and Khun Thep Chai Yong is now joining me online good evening สวัสดีค่ะ Khun Thep Chai
good evening Khun Natha and everybody another day of good news and I love saying that Khun Natha and I hope that I can keep saying this for the next 1 month because yes. The next 1 month will be very crucialin the fight against the coronavirus. Because we had only 2 new infections reported today, and it seems that many other countries around the world have already or either on the verge of easing their lockdowns, including countries like Russia, despite the fact that the country now is considered to be a new hotspot for Europe for the coronavirus, and being the 3rd most affected countryin terms of infections. And in UK, Khun Natha, Prime Minister Boris Johnson has just announced a new strategy to reopen the economy. But of course, the plan has come under heavy criticism for being too vague and confusing. We talk about these later in the program, Khun Natha.
Yes, very good news indeed. At least we see how the global trend is moving toward easing restriction and lifting the lockdown, Khun Thep Chai, after about 2 months.That the whole world is fighting in curbing coronavirus disease. And as Khun Thep Chai told us from the very beginning, today the new infection cases in Thailand is about 2. So it's quite low by Thai standard. It's lower than 10 single digit number, which is very crucial, Khun Thep Chai, because we've been told that if we keep this in single digit for at least 2 weeks, so,the easing of restriction in second phase will finally happen this week.
Yeah, this will be certainly a very favorable factor for the authorities to consider the second phase of the easing of the restrictions. As we have reported earlier that a number of businesses and activities will be allowed to resume in the middle of this month, most likely.Of course, we can keep the number of new infections down to the rate it is now. I think that is possible because we have been able to contain that number, to a large extent in the past 1 week anyway.
Yes, and overall, amidst good news that we see around the world, we have to also bear in mind that second wave of coronavirus outbreak is probably happening in South Korea, in China, and in Singapore, in which is quite close to Thailand as well, because these 3 countries are in Asia, and we are told time and again by spokesperson of CCSA that the guard has still remained quite high in order to cope with coronavirus.
Yeah, and what is happening in these countries certainly serve as a good reminder for Thailand.Which is, as we know, is moving toward easing more of the restrictions. So let's see how we can learn from these countries. But Khun Natha, the fallout from the pantries for happiness, pantry for sharing, the debate has continued today, and the Prime Minister himself, General Boruchan Chan-wicha, also has something to say about it. He was certainly quite dismayed by the fact that there were people scrambling,to get their hands on the donated items at these pantries, without regarding the fact that these items were supposed to be given out to people in need, not just to one single family or single person. But what we saw, in some isolated incidents, people just scoop up everything they could lay their hands on. And that certainly left the people that came later with nothing to take home.
Yes, and the picture that you have just seen on the screen, probably our team can show again, it's the pantry of sharing which just installed in front of Thai PBS station Kunthepchai at Vipavadi Rangsit Road, and it's in collaboration between Thai PBS and SCG Foundation. So this is the pantry of sharing right in the at the bus station, just right in front of Thai PBS station. And you can see the sign of People Station, one of our main program at the Thai PBS. And it means from now on, people can just take anything inside pantry of sharing in front of the Thai PBS station as well.
Yeah, there will be altogether 10 of these pantries in many locations. And certainly you are more than welcome to come with your donated items. I mean, instant noodles, packets of rice, a bottle of water to be put in these pantries to be given out to people who really need them.
Yes, Prime Minister has a cabinet meeting today and he has the words of appreciation toward private sector who has this idea of pantry of sharing, and that shows how Thai are willing to help each other during this difficult time, during this hardship because of coronavirus. So that should be a good example of how Thai are helping one another.
Yeah, he certainly would want to see a more orderly distribution of essential items through these pantries. So he called on people not to fight, I mean, to be the first to get these items. So, I mean, he certainly want to see Thai people better behave in time of crisis like this.
Yes, at least we see sign of hope from Pantry of Sharing Kunthepchai. And it's not only in Bangkok because it's scattered in many locations around the country in which people can share happiness via this pantry. People can take away things and they can also put things to keep pantry full as well.
Okay. That's the gesture that we certainly see as very inspiring in this time of crisis like this. So certainly, I mean, you as I said, you are more than welcome to come forward with donated items to either the pantries managed by Thai PBS together with SCG Foundation or other pantries that are close to where you live.
Yes. And right now, many activities, business activities around the country must be preparing to get themselves ready in terms of easing of restriction in the second phase. And cabinet meeting, CCSA will make a decision and they will have a major meeting this Friday, Kunthepchai, and make a decision what will happen during the second phase of easing restriction. So it's something to look forward to, especially among business activity, business owners in Thailand.
We have conducted a rough surveys of many business establishments. And we found that operators of many shopping malls, department stores, or major businesses are certainly well prepared for reopening. Some department stores have even prepared their employees and their workers, I mean, to be ready to welcome a new flood of customers once their businesses are allowed to reopen.
Yes. And for cash handouts of 5,000 baht, right now, people who have difficulty or would like to have this cash handout, cash relief, they still have time until 15th of May to submit the documents to the finance ministry. So document that they have to be prepared, identification card, banking account and their address so that they can try for last opportunity. This is the last stretch at public relations department that they can go and submit documents. And they will have to go through all the filter process whether they are eligible to get the cash handout. This is part of government's policy to try to help people during this crisis of coronavirus outbreak, Khun Thep Chai?
Yes, when we look around the world, it's quite clear that many countries are more than ready to reopen the economy, because we all know that the impact from the coronavirus on the economies of most countries has been quite severe. I mean, people are out of jobs, businesses have closed, so many countries are certainly just a step away from reopening businesses and try to get their economic back in order. For example, like in UK, Kunata, Prime Minister Boris Johnson has announced a strategy to reopen the economy and urging people who cannot work from home to go back to work. I mean, it's a reversal of the earlier directive for people to work from home. But the problem is that many people see his plan as being too confusing and too vague. And so that means that his government needs to do more homework to get the people to really understand the gist of this proposal.
Yes, it's very interesting, Khun Thep Chai, because I watched his live question and answer last night, Thailand time, and he got many questions from people around the UK, and he keeps repeating the point of people have to keep social distancing, and people who want to go back to work, if they can, they should go back to work. But there is no quite exact procedure or exact regulation what the business community should do in order to have proper function to allow people to get back to work and keep social distancing at the same time. So it must be quite confusing for British people what they should do. And I got some feedback that people say they rather stay home because they feel that it's much safer to stay home at this point.
That's right. He also changed the official message from his government to the people. It used to be stay at home, right? But now he has adopted a new message, that which is stay alert. That means that the people should go back to work if they need to, but in the process try to stay alert.
Yes.
So, but this is also has drawn quite a chorus of disapproval from many quarters, who believe that the strategy is not very clear, urging people, I mean, to go back to work if they need to, and to avoid using public transport. I mean, it's very, I mean, in part, I mean, for us, I mean, it can also be confusing.
That's right. And people are quite alert in a way. They are listening to what the Prime Minister of the UK has been saying quite closely, and they have to make their own decision whether to get back to work. And another spot in terms of coronavirus outbreak right now, we should take a look at Russia, because right now the number of new infection cases in Russia each day is quite high, and the total cases right now is more than 200,000 around the country. And right now we have Thai ambassador to the Russian Federation joining us live. So now let's welcome Ambassador Thanathip Upatthisingh. Good evening, Ambassador. สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีครับคุณรัฐฐาครับสว
ั
สด
ี
ครับคุณเทพชัยครับ
ค่ะ
Welcome to the program.
So, how are you with the Russian situation? Can you just tell us how do you manage yourself? Do you mostly stay in the embassy these days?
In fact, yesterday I just went out to the airport to send out 97 Thais back to Thailand.
Okay, so.
Just yesterday, the measures for lockdown of Moscow and other part of Russia has been eased by the president of Russia. Right now, you can have like the sectors on agriculture, on construction, and also industrial and energy can be resumed.
Quite soon. So for how long that Russia has lockdown strategy? Not too long?
Almost 6 weeks. In fact, the border has been closed between China and Russia since mid of February this year. And at the same time, by March 30th, the president of Russia has announced non-working days for Russia.
I see. When they use the term non-working days, what does it imply? What kind of restriction it entails?
Well, it's work from home, and in certain part of the sectors like grocery, banking, and still open. While the government sectors, like the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Russia, has informed all the embassies here to not to contact them at the headquarters, just only to contact through phone and teleconference.
I see. Yeah. And how did most of the embassies, including Thai embassy, of course, manage during the so-called non-working period?
Well, for us, we still come to work every day as normal because it does not include us the embassy. And at the same time, there are a lot of Thai living in Russia who seek to return to Thailand. So far, we have managed to send back around 220 Thais back to Thailand with four flights. And there will be another two flights coming next week and before the end of May.
Yeah. Ambassador, we know that Russia is very large country, and you said you send Thai people to return home, 97 of them. And where are they from in Russia? And how long that you have to collect these people to have the same flight together?
In fact, it's not an easy task. What we have to do, we communicate with our Thai people in Russia through our Facebook. If you check our Facebook, you would realize that we are the most frequent use of this social media in the world for the Thai embassy. For yesterday flights, we informed them about 2 days before. Most of the passengers come from St. Petersburg and also from from Moscow. 97 altogether. In fact, we got a quota for 99 people, but somehow two didn't turn up.
I see.
Unfortunately.
So these are students or Thai workers?
Well, they are workers and some are Thai students because the university here is still open, even though they learn it by online, but the course is still on.
But how was life for them under the non-working the condition? Do you have any idea?
As far as we can, well, during the first period when the Moscow was locked down, not many people come out on the street because the government asked most of the people to get the e-pass, and they can come out twice a week for working. But for grocery, they can go to the nearest grocery to their place, not longer than 150 meters, and they can walk the dog. So at the initial stage, people seem to respect and abide with the measures. But for the last 2 weeks, somehow, most of the people just come out, especially on the 9th of May, which was the victory day to celebrate the Second World War that they win. So most of the people just come out on the street, celebrate. So you can see that the outbreak of the infected rate increased lately.
That's right,
Ambassador, and how do people cooperate with lockdown strategy and cooperation with the government, like social distancing, wearing masks, washing hands? Do people cooperate well with the measures?
Yes, like yesterday when the easing of measures for lockdown in Moscow, taking into account people must wear masks and also gloves in the public place. But for the theater, department store still closed, entertainment restaurant still closed. But as I mentioned to you, those sectors in agriculture, in energy, and also in the industrial, they are still they can operate now.
I see. Ambassador, the easing of the lockdown in Russia comes despite the fact that the country is now a new hotspot of coronavirus, and now Russia is the third most affected country in terms of infections. So what is the reaction of the people to find themselves in this situation, Matt, being the hotspot of the virus, and that, and yet the lockdown is being eased? Are there fears that there could be a new round of infections if things may go wrong?
Thank you for asking this one.
Yeah.
Because yesterday I was quite lucky. Among 97 passengers, 5 are Thai medical students. So I talked to them. I said, look, tomorrow I will have to give an interview to Thai PBS. The question to be asked to me will be this. So those Thai doctors, a medical doctor, said that the mortality rate here is quite low, less than 1%. And then actually we show the capacity of testing and also treatment, medical treatment, because not many people died, less than 1%, and the recovery rate is quite high.
I see.
So those Thai students said we can be a bit relaxed because the Russian government is quite capable. And if you look at the figure, you can see that nowadays more than 5.8 million people got tested already. And the president of Russia, Mr. Putin, has announced to increase the capacity of testing equipment to 180,000 a day. So by mid of May, there will be 200,000 people tested daily.
That's a lot.
So far only 107 people have died according to the latest figures, and the total of the death is 2000 something.
2116.
Ambassador, but with the total confirmation cases of Russia is the second highest after the United States, what's the mentality, what's the sentiment among Russian people right now, as far as you can see?
Well, there is a pressure from the public, from the business sector. The president, President Putin, had 6 meetings through conference call with the head of regions, 86 regions. And as you can see, Russia is a big country. So President Putin gave authority to the governor and also head of territories to decide. He's quite flexible. And you can see that in his fifth meeting with the head of a region, he mentioned that Russia is an old country and abide to the social value. So they won't, I mean, he won't sacrifice the life of the people for the economy. He also reads like a book of Jack London, which is the life, the truth of life or something. So in that book, he said, and all Indians will be left with food and fire in order to let the rest of the tribe continue their journey. But and he also mentioned about Sparta, which is Greece, Greek, ancient Greek. that Sparta always, I mean, those baby who is not strong enough, they will leave those baby to die. This won't happen to Russia, because Russia grow up because of their ancestor who teach them to do everything. So he's not going to sacrifice the life of an old people with the economy. So they will go through the epidemic together. And once epidemic is over, then he will concentrate on reviving the economy.
But how have Russian people reacted to this kind of statement?
Russian people, they are quite they like their leader very much, especially for the visionary leader like President Putin. So most of the people will follow him.
I see. So his message has struck the right chord among the people then.
Yes, very heart touching.
Yeah, it seemed quite. He has his own way to describe and having unity, words of unity among people. And what about the situation of medical personnel in Russia, Ambassador? You said testing can be conducted quite a lot. And what about the capacity of medical personnel?
In fact, what President Putin has done, he has prolonged the outbreak of COVID-19 from the beginning. If you follow the news closely, you will see that Russia is the last country that got infected by COVID-19. So Russia is delayed for 6 weeks. And during that period, the medical equipment, like the hospital bed, has been increased from 260,000 to 130,000 in order to accommodate with the severe case. Moreover, the ventilators equipment has been produced up to 65,000 units, which is prepared for the serious case. And from yesterday's meeting, President Putin has announced a bonus for the medical team who spend most of their time in order to combat with COVID-19. But for Russia, this is not the second break, because the first break, you know, has not yet arrived. The outbreak.
Yeah.
I mean, if you follow the news, like, I mean, if you look at the history, like Spanish flu in 1918 to 1920, it took about a year for the second wave.
That's right.
So the first wave has not yet arrived.
Ambassador, in Thailand, as you know, people who are hard hit by the pandemic have been given the subsidies and other forms of assistance. What about in Russia? What kind of assistance programs has the government come up with to help those affected by the outbreak?
The employers are requested to pay while their business is closed. But we still receive like a complaint from those employees. So most of the people will get leave without pay from the beginning.
I see.
And what about the fire at St. Petersburg yesterday that killed five patients at the intensive care unit? How do people respond and what's the sentiment?
Well, what I received from the news is that five died in the fire. And at the same time, everything is under control.
Yeah. So Ambassador, when do you plan to have the next batch of Thai people in Russia to return to Thailand?
hopefully on the 19th of May.
Okay.
So and also on the 25th of May. But this is what we are trying to work out with Aeroflot and also with the authority CAT in Thailand.
Yes.
And all the Thais, and as far as you know, all the Thais there are safe and healthy, right?
Well, they are healthy. In fact, the embassy, you know, has dispatched the COVID-19 amenity to them. I myself went 4 times around Moscow in order to talk with the Thai people. As far as we can see, they still live happily. Their employers are very generous. Some of the companies even leave the cars, you know, for the employees to drive for grocery shopping.
Yeah, very generous. And no reports of infections among these Thai people, right?
So far, no. But the last batch that we sent back to Thailand, one got infected. That's what we received from Thailand report.
Ambassador, with capacity of testing 200,000 a day, what's the procedure? Can people just walk into the hospital and have themselves tested?
Yes. In fact, you know, before coming to your program, I just had the PCR test downstairs because for us at the embassy, we have to engage most of the time with the Thai people that we need to send back to Thailand. And just yesterday or a day ago, 97 Thais came here in order to get fit to fly certificate to meet with the doctors.
Okay, so you have done PCR on yourself as well?
Yes. I have done for 3 times now.
Okay. Oh,
so far, good, so good.
Wow.
Congratulations.
So do you really have abundant equipment?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Ambassador, for joining us. Stay well and keep safe.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you so much. Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Thank you.
ขอบคุณค่ะ
Okay.
Yes.
That's our man in Moscow. Being safe after a few rounds of medical checkup. So.
Yeah.
And being able to bring back many Thais. I mean, and the good news is that, that so far we have received no reports of Thais in Russia being infected, with the exception of one of them who returned recently. And were reported to be infected once they are in Thailand.
It seems Russia is coping quite well, Khun Thepchai, even though it's the second largest in terms of infection after United States. But as Ambassador said, because the mortality rate is quite low among Russians.
Yeah. So in Russia, they don't call the stringent measures at being shut down. They call it non-working period.
Yeah.
So. That basically it means working from home, but you're still working, but not as much as you are supposed to do on a normal basis.
Yes, that's another attempt from us, because if you have been following our program from the very beginning, we try to have voices from around the world to reflect the situation of coronavirus, how each country has been coping with the outbreak.
And we are glad to be reporting more and more good news. How countries and people are recovering, and how many societies are reopening too. So I think that's good news, because we are sick and tired of reporting mortalities, fatalities or infection rates as we did in the beginning of this pandemic. So but we are now reporting more and more good news. Yeah.
Yes. So it's second wave of our reporting more good news. That's good. And. When talking about industry which has been hit quite hard by coronavirus is the airline industry, Khun Thepchai. But we see the spirit of pilots, of flight attendants, of airline worker that they try to bring that skill and use that skill in other industry. Like this airline worker, he has swapped himself, he has become delivery man during this difficult time. So let's take a look at this report.
In the past, Kosit Ratanasopon was a grounded airline worker. Now, he is a delivery man, carries food to customers around Bangkok on his stylish Ducati motorbike ever since the airline he works for grounded all flights due to the escalating coronavirus outbreak last month. Trading his cabin crew uniform for a delivery jacket has been tough, but Kosit said he is making more than 1,000 baht a day, just enough to support his dad and sister, who also cook dozens of food boxes that Kosit helped to sell online. Faced with an uncertain future, Kosit said he's been stressed out, but riding motorbike at work has helped him cope. I love motorbikes. Everyone who rides a motorbike probably understands that riding a bike makes you feel free and less stressed. The stress is still there, but it can be compensated. I don't feel devalued working as a food delivery driver. Every job has its value and it can earn money.
So that's the man who, even though he cannot be airline worker right now, he has become delivery man instead.
Yeah, it's quite admirable how people managed in this very difficult time. Yeah.
And Khun Thepchai, as you told us that you do not want to talk more about bad news, but probably we have to stay alert following UK Prime Minister. And talking about second wave and cluster of infections right now, probably China and South Korea do not want to hear this, but it's happening in South Korea. And Khun Nat Bun Nak has the story for us. Hello, Khun Nat.
Hello.
Yeah, talking about South Korea, so suddenly they have new cluster of infections and related to nightclub. So can you tell us more?
Okay, so as of today, there are more and more infections that are related to this new cluster. So the new cluster is in Itaewon. Nothing to do with Itaewon class, but it's related to Itaewon nightclubs and the bars. So as of today, the CDC or the Korea Centers for Disease Control and Prevention announced that there are 102 confirmed cases that are related to the Itaewon cluster, and 64 cases are actually in Seoul. So that is a very big cluster of infections in Seoul at the moment. And the current infection toll at the moment is around 10,936 infections already, with the number of deaths standing at 258. So we might seeing that South Korea is facing the second wave of infections, as previously reported that South Korea managed to control the situation, but because of the number of infections that are rising from the Itaewon clubs here, so there is a possibility that South Korea might face the second wave here.
So it might be a nightmare for South Korea because they may have felt that they have already controlled the situation. So how do they
Definitely.
Cope with the new cluster of infection? Do they have introduced new stricter measures?
So far, they have imposed an administrative order to suspend business at clubs, bars, and other nightlife establishments. So ever since the news of Itaewon clubs and people getting infected by COVID-19 from this area, they have decided to close off all clubs and night bars to prevent the resurgence of COVID-19 there, and the measures will still remain in place until further notice. So at the moment, there's no end date on when they will actually ease the measures for nightclubs and bars. Besides this, all the authorities also went through mobile phone data, credit card statements, and as well as CCTV footage to identify people who already visited the nightclubs at Itaewon. So even though there's a group of people who already got identified and went through testing, there's also another group of people who they did not manage to identify who has went through the nightclubs during the time that the person who got infected by COVID-19 during the
time. To, so according to
let me,
media. Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, so if we can give you a little bit of a recap of how it started. It all started from this man who was tested positive for COVID-19 after visiting around five clubs and bars in Itaewon, which is around the 1st and the 2nd of May. And there are reports saying that more than 1,500 people were believed to have visited those places during that time. So health authorities are urging these people to get tested. And so far, the mayor of Seoul have secured a list of people who already went to these places at the same time that the man went to the clubs and bars on May the 1st and May the 2nd. So the people who have went to these places have already been receiving text messages urging them to go through virus screening.
Now, according to media reports in South Korea, the health authorities are trying to track about 5,000 people who visited bars in that area between the last week of April and the first weeks of May. But according to these reports, half of them still cannot be reached. So it's quite a challenge for the health authorities there to try to get in touch with these people and get them tested.
Yeah, so that's why they have to go through like all the data through mobile phone providers, credit card statements, as well as the CCTV footage, because there are still tons of people who they did not manage to identify and actually get these people to get tested for COVID-19.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm sure that what is happening in Korea, in Seoul right now, will be a factor that Thai health authorities will take into account when they evaluate the decision to opening to the second phase of the easing of the restriction, which would, of course, people have been talking about relaxing restrictions on restaurants, on nightclubs, and bars like this. So what's happening there in South Korea certainly will be a strong reminder to health authorities here as to what kind of approach they should take.
Yeah. When I heard of the case of Itaewon, it reminded me of our first series of cluster of infection from Tonglo area during mid of March. So probably, as Khun Thepchai said, the public health official will have to take this story into account. So thank you very
because,
much.
Thank you.
Sorry, Khun Nat, go ahead.
What I was going to say is bars and clubs is very at risk of getting COVID-19 because of the atmosphere itself. When we go to bars and clubs, there's got to be tons of people crowded together, whether they're dancing to music or drinking. So, of course, it's the Itaewon King here. It's definitely a good reminder that please do not open bars or nightclubs at this time, because at this time, it's definitely at risk of resurgence. So these are the places that should not be reopened at the moment. Same with like boxing stadiums that were at risk at the time.
Yeah, it's not certainly not in second phase, drafting of the second phase of easing restriction. Thank you very much, Khun Nat.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And Khun Thepchai, many countries around the world have reopening the country after a long period of lockdown. And one of them is France. They have already reopened. And now many business activities has been back to life. So let's take a look at this report.
Paris public transport and traffic was busy in some areas. As France lifted a number of lockdown measures on Monday, which had been in place for 2 months. France, the country that has official death toll as the world's sixth highest, had enforced an 8-week lockdown since March 17 to slow the spread of the coronavirus outbreak. President Emmanuel Macron's government decided to lift the lockdown after the number of patients in intensive care fell to less than half the peak of over 7,000 seen in early April. Some restrictions will remain in place, particularly for travel, until the situation is reassessed in early June. Masks are required on public transport, and operators must ensure social distancing. Shops, hair salons, and some other businesses in France were allowed to reopen on Monday. Additionally, residents no longer need to fill out special permission slips to leave the house. Stores implemented hygiene measures with staff wearing face masks and offering hand sanitizer to customers as they arrived. Despite this, there were relatively few people on the streets or in shops or cafes. Najla Bami, doctor at Henri Mondor Hospital, says she wasn't really confined as she is a doctor and she has worked a lot. She came after her night shift to buy some creams and shampoos as she didn't have time to do this before, just to take care of herself a little bit after these 2 months that have been very hard for her. Cedric Boudelard, one of the customers, says the shop has done things well from the beginning to the end. He washes hands at the entrance. There are marks on the ground and at the cash register. The cashier doesn't touch the products. It is very well organized. Until today, France has recorded over 177,000 COVID-19 cases and more than 26,000 deaths, according to Johns Hopkins University.
And what's the situation in Thailand, and how does public health official who has been working on this from the very beginning will evaluate the situation in Thailand? Right now we have Dr. Thanarak Phalipat, Deputy Director General of Department of Disease Control, joining us live. Swadika Kunmore.
Dr. Thanarak, thank you for joining us again tonight. I have a feeling that Bangkok has returned to the same old Bangkok as we knew. Traffic jams, a lot of people out on the street. So I'm afraid that you will need to keep saying what you have been saying all along. Don't be too complacent. Don't let your guard down.
Right.
I think that's what doctors are supposed to do. Keep reminding patients and people to take drug, to take their medicines, and not to be good with their conduct, right?
Right. That's right. That's right. I can understand how people has been affected by this COVID-19, because everybody, including me, and everyone I know has been affected by the virus. So whenever they evaluate, probably they evaluate the situation themselves and find out that probably now it's safer than ever. So that's what they may think. But the truth is that this is still not that very safe. Everybody still have to realize there is some level of risk out there. So that is why we including me, keep reminding everybody every time I have a chance that we still have to work very hard, and there's still a long, long ways to go. If we compare this with running, this would be something like a marathon, and we are just in the beginning of our very first few kilometers. That's
not all. Not even halfway. You mean?
No. I would like to, to say some nice things also, but the truth is that we are not very close. We are in just the beginning of very few kilometers. So we have to, yes, this is quite a long run. So we have to balance ourselves doing. So at some certain point in times, we may want to do something, and at different point in times, we may think about doing some other things. I myself would like to remind once again that we are not out of the wood yet. It is not the time to celebrate yet. But in the meantime, I can also understand that things has to, some part of the city has to at least to try to go back to live in some ways. I mean, to try themselves to put things together so they, some business can continue at some risk, as low as possible. That is what I would like to see, and I would like everybody to be aware at any times that wherever they goes, that there may be some risk there, and how they can minimize that risk. As long as we knew what the level of risk would be, and we knew how to minimize the risk, I think that would be fine.
Dr. Thanarat, so far we have seen how Thai people coping with the restriction, trying to keep social distancing, wearing masks when go outside, and when meeting people whom we don't know, and try to wash hands as often as we can. So far, are you happy with what Thai people have done, especially during this period, because the government is going to review the details of second phase of easing restriction?
You mean the last, just only the last 7 days, the last week, right? Or the whole, from the beginning of yeah. the situation?
Yeah. The reason a few weeks ago, because it yeah. seemed that people have tried to adjust, especially in terms of keeping social distancing. So far, do you think it's quite all right? Or
yes.
should we do
yes.
more?
I think in some degree, yes. Everybody's going out is still wearing, a lot of people still wearing masks. Very few though may not, but that's understandable. Everybody's trying in some ways to keep their risk as low as they can. They try to avoid the crowded place as much as they can. And I think that is very good to me. But let's put it this way: we can minimize the risk of everybody by doing two things. If we are just individuals and we are just employees, what we can do is that we try to minimize the risk. As I said, we don't go out if it is not necessary. We wear a mask and we clean our hands as often as we can. But on the other hand, there are some people who is responsibility or the owner of factories, of the office, of the company, or the one who can make change to the place, to the companies. Those are also very important person, and they have some responsibility as well. I'm not going to put all of the responsibility to any individuals, because some of the decision to do some things or not to do something is not up to them. Let's say if their companies said that everyone have to come back to work, then if I'm their employees, I have to go to work if I still want to keep my job. So this kind of decision, is this not at the individual level? Is this at the company level or at the factory level? Or the owner of those places have to make some decision on what they want to do or how they would like to do it. There are still certain rules or certain practices that we would like to for them to do. For example, if they can continue to let their employees work from home at certain numbers, certain proportion, that would be great, so that their offices will not be so crowded. If they can do some things continue to do something. For example, if they can screen everyone coming to the office, that will be also great. And if they can ask all of their employees wearing masks at all times, that would be great as well. As so many practices that they can do so that their employees can be very safe. And in the meantime, if their companies or if their places also give services to their customers, if they keep these practices, all of their customer will be safe as well. And as situation go on, I believe that every customers will look for the service or the places that's safe for themselves as well. So it is a win-win situation for me. Probably I can say win-win-win because the company also will win. The employees also will feel very safe and probably will also help the company as well. And the customer will also understand the situation, and the whole society is also get the benefit from what each and every one of us do.
Yeah. Dr. Tanaraka, you can be frank and straightforward with your answer to these questions. How much longer do you think that we will need to keep wearing masks and keeping social distancing and washing our hands as we have been doing? How much longer do we need to do that?
Okay. This is easy question for me. For work from home, I think this should be the norms for the future for the big city like Bangkok. Everyone, every company, every government, every ministry should try to ask or should try to set up the system so that every civil servants, every government employees, every staff of the government sectors should work from home as much as possible at any times, even when COVID is ended. Because work from home is benefit not just only for COVID, it's benefit for all of the respiratory diseases. It's help our environment. PM 2.5 will be better. Traffic will be better. We will spend less time on the road in the cities. So this work from home or remote working should stay, definitely. So if I can, and actually we are preparing the document, the suggestion to the governments that this should stay, not only for the government sectors. There are, as I jump into this, there are a lot of research saying that work from home, remote work, increase productivity of their employees. So plus so many things. Employees save money from traveling to the office, going back, although they have to pay some electricity bill. But that's who upset. So for the work from home, to try to keep social distancing, I think this should stay, and to stay for whenever we can do it. So there are so many sectors that have to come in, so many sectors. The government sectors, our Ministry of Digital Economies, those ministry have to jump in and try to set up and build up our infrastructure so that not just the government part, but also the private sectors can also benefit from this policy of work from home. This is one part that I think it should be the new normals. And it was not, to me, I think we have been talking about work from home or remote work for some time. And in other countries in Europe and in America, it's already a trend, not a new norm. New employees will request to work from home even more and more. They are more productive at home. There are so many reasons, safer to work from home for most of the employees. So for us, we are following that trend, and I think COVID will just accelerate those change, should accelerate those change to the faster pace. That is one thing that I would like to see. Second things for the wearing mask, when COVID end, I still would like to see that if anybody has respiratory symptoms, like for example have cough, have cold. I would like to see our Thai people wearing masks when they felt ill with respiratory symptoms, just like Japan. Okay. If you have a cold, you should wear a mask. That will prevent others from getting cold from you. And I think that's a very good practices, and I would like to see it stay. So as so many practices that COVID came and taught us a lesson, there are still so many things that I think that we are practices today that should stay for a longer period of time. For those practices, I would like to see it change, not because of COVID, but COVID come in and help us realize that we should do it. Another example I can give you is what the government has been saying for a while. For example, digital transformation. Mm-hmm. For the private sectors, they already go ahead very fast. But for the government sectors, I think we are still very far behind. There are so many things that that's everybody as Thai citizens should be able to do from home online. And we don't have to go to the government places to do certain things and have to stay in line for a very, very long time. That should not happen. And I think this is something that COVID came in and make us think about almost everything. When we talk about work from home, one of the arguments for the government employees would be that not everything that we can work from home. Of course, yes, because there are some public services that we still have to do. But if we think harder and if we use our different mindset, we will see that certain part of those jobs can be done somewhere else, not has to be done at government offices. Mm-hmm. So this is something I would like to see stay.
Yeah,
and cool. I think it will help government and every private sector as well.
Yeah, we need a whole new mindset, I mean, to be able to achieve that. Yeah. Mm.
Yes, that's right.
And Dr. Tanarak, right now we see how many countries around the world are easing the lockdown, easing the restriction, and closer to us are new cases of infection in China, in South Korea. What Thailand should learn from this, especially these two countries?
Yeah. First, nobody can, this is too much. It is very hard to in countries. We have to work harder than this if we want to reduce our number of cases into zero cases. What we can do is try to limit the number of cases to be at the lowest point as possible and keep it that low for a long, long times. For the plan of doing this continuously, what we should do is that we should try to keep our guard on and keep our guard up and trying our best to keep the number as low as possible. We have already set up the guideline numbers for the government. For example, it is not a magic number, but just give you a rough ideas. For example, we may say that if we have the number of cases lower than about 5 cases per 1 million population per day, we are still okay. So those will be roughly about, if our provinces have 1 million population, it means that we can have about 5 cases per day, we will still be okay. So it don't have to be zero, it don't have to be 1 or 2 cases per day for the whole countries. We have some numbers that we can work with, but those are the upper limit. Those are the upper limit, not the lower limit. So what we should do is we try to keep our number low, and when we start to see our number go up, we should try our best to keep it lower than our limit.
Okay. Dr. Tanarak, is the connection okay?
Yes.
Okay, you can hear us.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's right.
Thank you very much for talking to us in English version. And I'd like you to see, to watch this clip together with our audience as well, because in Colombia, it's the first fresh air for young kids that they can have fresh air after 48 days of mandatory lockdown. And then we will return to talk to you in Thai version. So stay with us.
Children over 6 years old in Bogota are allowed out for half an hour during certain time periods as some sectors, including computer stores, begin to open up after a time lockdown.
Me he sentido feliz porque después de 2 meses de encierro, pues me he sentido aburrida en ese encierro y ya me siento feliz después de haber...
The children said they felt very happy because after the 2 months of confinement, they felt bored, locked up, and now they are able to breathe some fresh air.
Bueno, la medida de que los niños ahora puedan salir 30 minuticos a la calle, pienso que debemos alargarla media horita más.
One of the parents stated that, I think the measure that children can go out for half an hour is very good. I think that we should extend it by half an hour more. 30 minutes maybe is very little, but it is a great measure that the Bogota administrator has taken. And this helps psychological development after being locked up for so long.
ค่ะท่านผู้ชมคะทุกๆวันอังคารนะคะเราจะมีคุณหมอท่านนายแพทย์ธนรักษ์ผลิตพัฒน์รองอธิบดีกรมควบคุมโรคมาประเมินสถานการณ์โควิด-19 และมาตรการต่างๆที่กำลังเกิดขึ้นช่วงนี้คุยกับคุณหมอต่อเป็นภาษาไทยค่ะ
ครับ
ค่ะ
ครับสวัสดีครับ
ครับสวัสดีครับคุณหมอครับประธานาธิบดีโดนัลด์ทรัมป์ของสหรัฐไม่ได้เรียนแพทย์ไม่ได้เป็นหมอนะแต่ว่ามักจะมีความเห็นทางด้านการแพทย์เสมอเลยคุณหมอล่าสุดเมื่อวานนี้ท่านก็บอกว่าไม่เป็นไรหรอกไอ้เจ้าไวรัสตัวนี้มันจะหายไปเองโดยไม่ต้องมีวัคซีนด้วยซ้ำไปเนี่ยผมควรจะเชื่อโดนัลด์ทรัมป์ไหมครับ
คงไม่หายไปไหนครับแล้วก็ผมเข้าใจว่ามันคงจะอยู่กับเราไปอีกสักพักใหญ่ๆหมายถึงว่าถึงแม้จะมีวัคซีนก็ตามนะครับเพราะโอกาสที่จะกำจัดให้มันหมดไปจากโลกเนี่ยเป็นเรื่องที่ค่อนข้างจะต้องใช้พลังกันค่อนข้างจะมากทีเดียวนั้นมันระบาดเยอะขนาดนี้แล้วเนี่ยโอกาสที่แต่ละประเทศเนี่ยจะกำจัดมันให้หมดไปจากประเทศทุกๆประเทศเลยเนี่ยจะเป็นเรื่องที่ซับซ้อนแล้วก็ยุ่งยากมากนะครับถึงแม้จะมีวัคซีนก็ตามเพราะฉะนั้นในอนาคตต่อไปมันก็คงจะคล้ายๆกับหลายๆโรคที่เราเจอกันอยู่ทุกวันอาจจะคล้ายๆกับไข้หวัดใหญ่ที่ยังไงเราก็ต้องสู้กับมันไปอีกพักใหญ่ๆนะฮะแต่ความหลังจากที่เรามีวัคซีนแล้วเนี่ยโรคเนี้ยมันจะคลายความน่ากังวลลงไปค่อนข้างจะมากตอนนี้ที่เรากังวลมากเนี่ยก็คือเรากังวลว่าเราจะมีเหตุการณ์การแพร่ระบาดหนักมากจนเราไม่มีเตียงพอที่จะรับคนไข้อาการหนักเหมือนกับอย่างที่แม้แต่ในสหรัฐอเมริกาเองในหลายเมืองในหลายรัฐเนี่ยก็กำลังประสบปัญหานี้อยู่แม้แต่ในอิตาลีนะครับแล้วก็ประเทศหลายประเทศในยุโรปที่กำลังเผชิญหน้ากับปัญหาขนาดนี้อยู่ถ้าเมื่อไหร่ก็ตามที่คนไทยเนี่ยมีภูมิกันเยอะพออยากจะให้มีภูมิกันด้วยการได้รับวัคซีนหลังจากนั้นโรคเนี้ยก็ยังคงจะเจออยู่แต่จะเจอในสัดส่วนที่น้อยลงแล้วถึงตอนนั้นเนี่ยมันจะไม่มีสิ่งที่เรียกว่าการระบาดแล้วมันจะกลายเป็นโรคประจำถิ่นละมันก็จะกลายเป็นเหมือนกับโรคหวัดโรคหนึ่งนะครับที่เราจะเจอได้ถ้าเกิดว่าใครไปสัมผัสเชื้อหรือติดเชื้อมาต รงนี้เนี่ยภายใต้สมมติฐานนะครับว่าวัคซีนที่ได้รับเนี่ยจะมีความสามารถในการป้องกันโรคได้ค่อนข้างดีแล้วก็นานพอสมควรแต่ถ้าเกิดว่าวัคซีนปรากฏว่าสร้างภูมิคุ้มกันได้ยังไม่ค่อยดีเท่าไหร่เราก็อาจจะต้องเจอปัญหาที่ซับซ้อนมากกว่าเดิมเข้าไปอีกสักหน่อยนะครับ
ก็แสดงว่าความหวังนี้ต้องอยู่ที่วัคซีนสำหรับการกลับมาใช้ชีวิตได้อย่างปกติอย่างที่คนทั่วไปเข้าใจกันนะคะคุณหมอแต่ว่าในช่วงสัปดาห์ที่ผ่านมาก็มีรายงานว่าเจ้าไวรัสเนี่ยอาจจะกลายพันธุ์ได้ตรงนี้จะยิ่งส่งผลกระทบต่อการคิดค้นพัฒนาวัคซีนยิ่งทำให้ความหวังที่จะได้วัคซีนนี้ช้าออกไปไหมคะ
ก็มีโอกาสครับแต่อยากจะเรียนอย่างนี้ครับว่าวัคซีนที่เราพัฒนากันมาเนี่ยบางตัวเนี่ยเชื้อไวรัสบางตัวเนี่ยสามารถมีความสามารถสูงมากในการเปลี่ยนแปลงตัวเองอย่างยกตัวอย่างเป็นไข้หวัดใหญ่นะไข้หวัดใหญ่วัคซีนไข้หวัดใหญ่เนี่ยตัวเชื้อไข้หวัดใหญ่ที่เราเจอทุกปีเนี่ยก็จะมีการเปลี่ยนแปลงอยู่ตลอดเวลาเชื้อไอ้วัคซีนที่จะเอาไปทำวัคซีนไข้หวัดใหญ่เชื้อไวรัสที่จะไปทำวัคซีนไข้หวัดใหญ่ก็จะมีการเปลี่ยนแปลงไปทุกปีเหมือนกันเพราะฉะนั้นเนี่ยถ้าเมื่อไหร่ก็ตามที่เราสามารถผลิตวัคซีนต้นแบบตัวแรกขึ้นมาได้นะครับผมเชื่อว่าเราก็จะมีวิธีการที่จะจัดการกับการเปลี่ยนแปลงของเชื้อไวรัสนี้ได้ด้วยเหมือนกันเพราะว่าอันนี้คือมองโลกในแง่ดีนะครับก็หวังว่าการเปลี่ยนแปลงมันจะไม่เร็วแล้วก็รุนแรงจนถึงขั้นที่ทำให้ตัววัคซีนเนี่ยมันไม่ได้ผลเลยหรือว่าฉีดไปก็ไม่มีประโยชน์อะไรเลยอย่างเงี้ยนะครับก็หวังว่ามันคงจะคล้ายๆไข้หวัดใหญ่ที่การเปลี่ยนแปลงมันขยับไปทีละนิดทีละหน่อยแม้ว่าวัคซีนจะไม่ตรงสายพันธุ์เป๊ะๆแต่การฉีดวัคซีนก็ยังมีประโยชน์เช่นอาจจะช่วยลดความรุนแรงของโรคอย่างนี้ได้อย่างนี้ก็น่าจะโอเคแล้วล่ะครับเพราะฉะนั้นก็หวังว่าตัววัคซีนที่ได้ออกมาในช่วงแรกจะเป็นวัคซีนตัวที่จะอย่างน้อยที่สุดก็จะลดอะไรบางอย่างลดผลกระทบบางอย่างจากการติดเชื้อได้แค่นั้นก็พอแล้วครับ
ให้คุณหมอครับไอ้เกาหลีใต้นะตอนแรกก็ดูเหมือนว่าจะเป็นแบบอย่างของการจัดการกับโคโรนาไวรัสได้ดีนะครับแต่ว่าตอนนี้ทำท่าจะเข้ามาสู่ระบาดรอบ2ซะแล้วนะครับเพราะว่ามีการไปค้นพบไอ้คลัสเตอร์ของการระบาดที่แหล่งบันเทิงที่เรียกว่าอีแตวอนนะครับมีคนป่วยจากแหล่งนั้นเป็นร้อยคนเลยเนี่ยมันบอกอะไรแล้วครับคุณหมอมันเป็นเครื่องเตือนใจอะไรระบางอย่างหรือเปล่าก่อนที่เราจะคิดถึงเรื่องของการที่จะผ่อนปลนในรอบต่อไป
ครับสิ่งหนึ่งที่สำคัญอยู่เสมอแล้วผมคิดว่าจะสำคัญตลอดไปเนี่ยคือเรื่องของความสมดุลระหว่างปัญหาสุขภาพกับเรื่องของเศรษฐกิจแต่ละประเทศเนี่ยต้องหาจุดสมดุลของตัวเองให้เจอจริงๆแต่ละประเทศเนี่ยมีศักยภาพทางด้านสาธารณสุขไม่เท่ากันเพราะฉะนั้นจุดสมดุลของแต่ละประเทศเนี่ยจะไม่เหมือนกันเราจะเรียนแบบประเทศอื่นเนี่ยก็คงไม่ได้เราอาจจะเรียนรู้บทเรียนจากเขาได้แล้วเราเอามาพยายามประยุกต์ใช้โดยพิจารณาความเสี่ยงกับเรื่องของศักยภาพที่เรามีเนี่ยเป็นหลักนะครับของเกาหลีใต้เนี่ยต้องยอมรับความจริงหลายอย่างเขาเป็นประเทศพัฒนาแล้วเป็นประเทศที่มีระบบสุขภาพพอก็ดีมากระดับหนึ่งของต้นๆของโลกเลยแล้วก็เขาก็มีความจำเป็นที่จะต้องดูแลเรื่องของเศรษฐกิจของเขาด้วยของเราก็คงต้องยอมรับความจริงว่าเราก็คงจะต้องดูแลตรงนี้ด้วยแต่ว่าแต่ละประเทศเนี่ยก็จะมีความยืดหยุ่นหรือว่าจะมีความสามารถที่จะจัดการกับปัญหาที่ระดับที่แตกต่างกันนะฮะเห็นของเกาหลีใต้เนี่ยเขาลดเขาพยายามเปิดเรื่องของเศรษฐกิจเร็วนะครับจริงๆทุกประเทศก็พยายามเต็มที่เหมือนกันที่จะหาสมดุลนี้ให้เจอแล้วก็พอเขามีปัญหาเขาก็ขันน็อตขึ้นอีกนะครับผมคิดว่าของประเทศไทยมันจะบอกกับอะไรคนไทยใช่ไหมครับ
ครับ
อันแรกเลยนี่ก็คือสถานที่เสี่ยงสูงเนี่ยอยู่จำนวนหนึ่งแล้วก็ถ้าเป็นไปได้จะชะลอการเปิดสถานที่เสี่ยงสูงพวกนี้ให้ชัด
คุณหมอคะคุณหมอยังได้ยินทางเราอยู่ไหมคะ
อาจารย์สะดุดหน่อย
ครับ
มันสัญญาณจะสะดุดนะคะ
ครับ
ค่ะคุณหมอเชิญลองพูดต่อเลยค่ะดูเหมือนจะมีปัญหาจริงๆเดี๋ยวจะใช้วิธีวางแล้วค่ะคุณหมอยังอยู่นะคะ ไม่อยู่แล้วนะคะอาจจะมีปัญหาเดี๋ยวลองวาง
ได้ยินอยู่ครับ
ได้ยินโอเคคุณหมอกลับมาครับเชิญต่อคุณหมอเชิญต่อครับ
เพราะฉะนั้นเนี่ยผมว่าบทเรียน2อันนี้นะครับก็คืออันแรกเอามาอีกทีนะครับก็คือเรื่องว่าเราจะต้องหาสมดุลของเราให้เจอนะครับหาสมดุลของเราให้เจอว่าเจอมาเดินไปได้นะครับด้านที่2เราจะต้องเข้าใจว่าเมื่อไหร่ก็ตามจำนวนผู้ป่วยเพิ่มขึ้นเราก็จะมีความจำเป็นที่จะต้องทำบางอย่างคือการเปิดน้ำถ้าเมื่อไหร่
คุณหมอคะขออภัยนะคะ
ตอนนี้เสียง
มีปัญหาขออภัยเดี๋ยวทางทีมจะขอวางสายแล้วจะติดต่อกลับไปทางคุณหมอใหม่นะคะเพื่อที่จะได้ให้สัญญาณชัดเจนนะคะขออภัยด้วยค่ะ
เรากำลังคุยคุณหมอธนรักษ์นะครับกำลังพูดถึงบางสิ่งบางอย่างที่ควรจะเรียนรู้ได้จากเกาหลีใต้นะครับซึ่งตอนแรกๆคุณณัฐาคงจำได้ใช่ไหมครับว่าถูกชูว่าเป็นภาพของสังคมที่ตอนนี้มีแนวทางชัดเจนในการจัดการกับโคโรนาไวรัสแต่ว่าอาจจะเป็นเพราะว่ามีการเปิดประเทศมีการเปิดทางด้านเศรษฐกิจเร็วไปหน่อยม
ัน
ก็เลยเปิดโอกาสให้มันมีการระบาดที่แพร่ออกไปอีกอย่างคาดไม่ถึงนะครับแล้วก็ล่าสุดไปพบว่ามันมีแหล่งที่เป็นคลัสเตอร์หรือเป็นกระจุกอยู่ในแหล่งบันเทิงแห่งหนึ่งที่ชื่อว่าอีเจวอนนะครับแล้วก็ตอนนี้กำลังตามหาคนหลายพันคนเลยนะครับที่เป็นนักท่องเที่ยวแล้วไปที่แหล่งนั้นเพื่อที่จะมาตรวจสอบดูว่าติดเชื้อบ้างหรือเปล่านะครับนี่ก็เป็นบทเรียนหนึ่งแน่นอนซึ่งจะเป็นประเด็นสำคัญที่เราเชื่อว่าทางเจ้าหน้าที่ของรัฐบาลไทยเนี่ยก็คงจะนำมาศึกษาก่อนตัดสินใจในการที่จะผ่อนปลนมาตรการทางด้านการล็อกดาวน์เนี่ยในขั้นตอนต่อไปนะครับ
ก็เป็นสถานการณ์ซับซ้อนที่กำลังกลับมาและก็เป็นช่วงเวลาในไทยที่กำลังพิจารณาเพื่อจะผ่อนปรนมาตรการในระลอกที่2นะคะคุณเทพชัยก็คงจะเป็นอีกหนึ่งสถานการณ์ที่ทางคณะทำงานก็คงจะนำกลับมาพูดคุยพิจารณาประกอบการตัดสินใจแล้วก็เป็นช่วงเวลาที่หลายๆประเทศก็กำลังเผชิญระลอกที่2ของการระบาดของโคโรนาไวรัสด้วยนะคะทางบุคลากรสาธารณสุขทั่วโลกก็คงจะเห็นแล้วว่าซับซ้อนอย่างมากกับการจัดการและถ้าไม่ได้รับความร่วมมือจากประชาชนจากภาคเอกชนหรือว่าภาคส่วนต่างๆเพื่อที่จะดำเนินมาตรการไปพร้อมๆกันเนี่ยก็ยากที่จะควบคุมสถานการณ์ไว้ได้ค่ะ
ครับผมว่าคุณหมอก็พูดชัดเจนนะครับว่าแต่ละประเทศก็มีสภาพสังคมภาวะทางด้านการเมืองที่แตกต่างกันไปนะครับเมื่อสักครู่ตอนต้นเราก็พูดถึงประธานาธิบดีโดนัลด์ทรัมป์ของสหรัฐซึ่งสายตาตอนนี้ก็เล็งไปที่นู่นเลือกตั้งประธานาธิบดีปลายปีนี้เป็นหลักแล้วล่ะเพราะฉะนั้นทุกอย่างก็อาจจะเป็นเรื่องรองบททุกอย่างที่ทำตอนนี้เพื่อนำปูทางไปสู่ความหวังว่าจะชนะการเลือกตั้งกลับมาสู่ทำเนียบขาวอีกครั้งหนึ่งเพราะฉะนั้นสื่อมวลชนที่อเมริกาก็ตั้งข้อสังเกตไว้เยอะมากนะครับว่าสิ่งที่ทรัมป์พูดทุกวันนี้หรือแสดงออกทุกวันนี้มันมีนัยยะทางการเมืองที่แอบแฝงอยู่มากทีเดียวมันไม่ใช่เป็นเรื่องของการสู้กับเรื่องโคโรนาไวรัสเพียงอย่างเดียวละมันเป็นการต่อสู้เพื่อเอาชัยชนะทางด้านการเมืองด้วย
ค่ะ
ครับก็คงเข้าใจมันมีปัญหากับคุณหมอธนรักษ์ทางด้านสัญญาณเชื่อมต่อใช่ไหมคุณณัฐา
ใช่ค่ะค่ะค่ะเดี๋ยวเราจะพยายามติดต่อคุณหมอเพื่อคุยกันต่อนะคะในช่วงท้ายนี้คุณหมอน่าจะมาทางเสียงนะคะเดี๋ยวลองทดสอบดูค่ะคุณหมอได้ยินทางเราไหมคะ
ได้ยินแล้วครับ
เอาละค่ะอ๋อคุณหมอกลับมาแล้ว
ค่ะก็ไม่ใช่พูดค้างถึงเรื่องบทเรียนที่เราควรจะได้จากที่เกาหลีนะครับ
ครับครับก็เอาใหม่เลยนะครับ
ได้ค่ะคุณหมอบอกว่าไม่มีสูตรสำเร็จแต่ละประเทศต้องแก้ปัญหากันเอง
ใช่ครับใช่ครับก็ผมว่าทุกประเทศจะต้องหาสมดุลของตัวเองที่จะให้เศรษฐกิจเดินได้ในขณะเดียวกันก็จะไม่มีผลกระทบกับสุขภาพมากจนเกินไปซึ่งแต่ละประเทศนี่จะมีลักษณะไม่เหมือนกันขึ้นอยู่กับหลายปัจจัยมากทั้งโครงสร้างพื้นฐานทางสาธารณสุขทั้งลักษณะนิสัยของแต่ละคนแล้วก็ทั้งวิธีการดำเนินชีวิตของแต่ละประเทศที่แตกต่างกันออกไปส่วนที่สองเนี่ยนะครับก็คือคนทุกคนจะต้องเข้าใจว่าเมื่อไหร่ก็ตามที่เกิดเหตุการณ์กลับขึ้นมาใหม่มีจำนวนผู้ป่วยเพิ่มขึ้นแล้วก็มีความจำเป็นครับที่จะต้องมีการใส่มาตรการบางอย่างให้เข้มข้นมากขึ้นไปตามไปด้วยนะครับ
คุณหมอว่าจะส่งผลหรือว่าช่วงเวลานี้ที่ไทยกำลังพิจารณาผ่อนปรนมาตรการระลอกที่2อาจจะมีความแน่ชัดออกมา15พฤษภาคมจ จะต้องคิดเรื่องนี้เป็นพิเศษไหมคะหรือว่าปัจจัยอะไรที่ทางไทยเองก็ต้องระมัดระวังนะคะ
ครับผมอยากจะเรียนอย่างนี้นะครับว่าหลังจากเหตุการณ์จากนี้เป็นต้นไปเนี่ยสิ่งที่จะต้องดูเนี่ยส่วนตัวผมมองว่าเราควรจะดูเป็นพื้นที่แคบๆแล้วเราไม่ควรที่จะตอบสนองทุกอย่างในลักษณะที่เป็นทั้งประเทศผมยกตัวอย่างนะครับถ้าสมมตินะครับว่าเกิดเหตุการณ์ระบาดขึ้นมาที่อำเภอเมืองจังหวัดอะไรสักจังหวัดหนึ่งนะครับภายในวันสองวันเนี้ยการที่เราจะพิจารณาว่าเราจะไม่เปิดห้างเลยในกรุงเทพมหานครเนี่ยมันจะตอบได้ยากเหมือนกันว่าทำไมต้องขนาดนั้นเพราะฉะนั้นเนี่ยในการจัดการกับปัญหาเนี่ยในอนาคตเนี่ยใจผมคิดว่าควรจะต้องพิจารณาดูว่าพื้นที่ไหนเป็นพื้นที่ได้รับผลกระทบแล้วก็เราจะจัดการกับปัญหาในพื้นที่นั้นด้วยมาตรการแบบไหนมาตรการสาธารณสุขยังพอรับมือไหวไหมมาตรการภาคขอความร่วมมือยังรับมือไหวไหมถ้าไม่ไหวก็คงจะต้องเริ่มพิจารณาเรื่องของการปิดสถานที่ที่มีการแพร่ระบาดหรือเป็นพื้นที่ที่เสี่ยงที่จะมีการแพร่ระบาดเป็นลำดับขั้นขึ้นไปก็เหมือนกับตอนที่เราทยอยเปิดทยอยปิดเนี่ยนะครับเน้นอุปมาอุปไมยตรงนี้เหมือนกับการเปิดปิดก๊อกน้ำนะครับถ้าสมมุติว่าเรามีอ่างอยู่ในอ่างนึงแล้วอ่างนี้ก็คือมีท่อระบายน้ำออกไปได้ถ้าน้ำมันไหลแรงมากถ้าน้ำนี่คือหมายถึงคนไข้แล้วก็มีน้ำค้างอยู่ในอ่างมากนะครับน้ำที่ไหลออกจากทางท่อใต้อ่างนี่ก็เหมือนกับคนไข้ที่รักษาหายเพราะฉะนั้นเนี่ยถ้าเกิดว่าน้ำมันเยอะมากไหลเร็วมากนะครับมันก็จะล้นอ่างภาวะน้ำล้นอ่างนี่ก็เหมือนกับภาวะคนไข้ล้นโรงพยาบาลเพราะฉะนั้นเมื่อไหร่ก็ตามที่น้ำไหลลงอ่างเร็วเกินไปเราก็จะต้องขันก๊อกสักนิดนึงให้น้ำมันไหลเบาลงเพื่อให้คนไข้ในโรงพยาบาลนี่จำนวนลดน้อยลงแล้วโรงพยาบาลสามารถจัดการกับปัญหาได้อุปมาอย่างนี้ครับเพราะฉะนั้นเนี่ยจังหวะของการเปิดการปิดน้ำของแต่ละพื้นที่แต่ละอำเภอแต่ละจังหวัดนี่ก็จะขึ้นอยู่กับว่าสถานการณ์ของแต่ละพื้นที่เป็นยังไงการที่เราเกิดการระบาดแค่พื้นที่เล็กๆเช่นอำเภอใดอำเภอหนึ่งหรือจังหวัดใดจังหวัดหนึ่งแล้วเราปิดธุรกิจทั่วประเทศเลยเนี่ยผลกระทบมันจะรุนแรงแล้วความเป็นจริงเนี่ยถามว่ามันเป็นการตอบโต้ที่มันเหมาะสมกับขนาดของปัญหาหรือเปล่าทุกคนก็จะตอบได้นะครับว่ามันไม่ได้เหมาะสมอะไรกันเลยนะถ้าระบาดที่อำเภอไหนก็ลงแรงที่อำเภอนั้นแล้วก็อะไรที่จำเป็นต้องทำก็ต้องเร่งลงไปทำที่อำเภอนั้นนะครับ
เอาละค่ะก็น่าจะเป็นการทบทวนแนวทางที่อาจจะเกิดขึ้นนะคะสำหรับในช่วงเวลานี้ที่ไทยก็กำลังพิจารณาเพื่อที่จะผ่อนปรนมาตรการในระลอกที่2ค่ะสำหรับวันนี้ขอบพระคุณคุณหมอมากนะคะที่มาประเมินสถานการณ์และให้ความรู้เพิ่มเติมทั้งภาษาไทยและภาษาอังกฤษค่ะขอบพระคุณคุณหมอค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีครับ
และลาคุณผู้ชมไปเลยนะคะสำหรับไทย PBS World Tonight ค่ะมีเสียงน้องๆขอบคุณบุคลากรทางการแพทย์ด้วยค่ะคุณเทพชัยสำหรับคืนนี้คุณเทพชัยและดิฉันสวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ
Hello everyone. Today I would like to give a big thank you for everyone who are the heroes of Thailand right now.
We know you are excited.
Thank you so much for all of your work, huh?
You are super duper heroes for us.
I promise to take care of myself.
Wash my hands often.
Wear a mask.
And stay at home.
Please take care of yourself too.
We hope that this crisis from COVID-19 will be gone in the near future.
Thank you again for everything.
Love you. Bye-bye.
In times of crisis,
it's been a nightmare.
What you need is accurate,
COVID-19,
up-to-date, and in-depth information.
This virus will be with us for a long time.
And in this most challenging time, when the whole world is being ravaged by the most frightening pandemic, there is no easier way to stay informed than to stay home.
Hello everyone.
Welcome to Thai PBS World Tonight.
And stay with us. Thai PBS World. We bring Thailand to the world.